you know, a little different than politics, but it's actually quite a bit more fun. So
I'm sure it is. I mean that's a great way to start it out, because you if people don't know, you were a senator, you were more recently ambassador to New Zealand, right? And that's kind of where this all took root. You were, first of all, I didn't even know that you were a musician, which is pretty surprising to me. But you started jamming with some guys in New Zealand, right?
Well, actually, I started about 7 years ago when I lost the election. I started playing, and the first five songs I learned were Cheap Trick songs. And then 4 months later, I'm playing at the Hampton Beach Casino with them. and it was pretty surreal. I mean, if you asked me to play a sixth song, I couldn't. But now I can, obviously, and played with them six times. The last time was in Australia. Played six songs, two finales, and you know, be playing with them again when they come up this way. But yeah, I mean, I did a lot of work on the music pirating and copyright issue, Bill, and that's how I met Rick Nielsen. And you know, the fact that I was able to play and then worked on that issue for them gave me some, you know, unusual credibility. So played with them and Warrant, Firehouse, Ayla, obviously James Montgomery, a bunch of different bands, and had a band in New Zealand. And I thought I would, and I enjoyed it, you know, very much. So I figured I'd do it here.
Yeah, everybody knows your daughter, Ayla Brown. She's an incredibly talented singer and musician. But you didn't, like, always play guitar. You said this was just, what, you
seven years
ago. You just started it. Look at you now. And now you got a whole band. It's Scott Brown and the Diplomats. And you guys will be opening for the Dark Desert Eagles over at Indian Ranch here in Webster. And I was thinking of other notable politicians who also had some kind of musical ability. Bill Clinton comes up with the saxophone. There was I think they were called the singing senators, like Orrin Hatch was involved. There was like some kind of a cappella group or something like that. And
Lamar Alexander's an amazing, if I'm not mistaken, Orrin has a Grammy, and I think maybe Lamar does too in
terms
of songwriting. They're all singer-songwriters, and I worked with them actually extensively on the Music Modernization Act, which is the bill the former president signed a couple of years ago. That's how long it took to get it done, to protect older artists so they could get paid, you know, with the new types of social media and music, you know, music streaming. But it's been fun certainly to learn new songs and participate. We've had two gigs so far. The last one was an $85 ticket sold out event down the Cape, and we have obviously Friday night we're going to be playing in Danvers at the Breakaway, and then Saturday we're on at 1:00 sharp. I think gates open at 12:00, and as you know, Indian Ranch, those people are just amazing. The owners are fantastic. They have great shows there. The people of Webster appreciate that venue. It's historic, and to be able to actually have my own band and play. Yeah, I played with Ayla once or twice up there. A song, she, you know, threw me a bone, but now it's my band, and we get 45 minutes to rock it out pretty hard.
So what kind of stuff do you guys play? Is it all covers? Do you have any kind of original stuff?
Yeah, all covers. We have some very talented people who will probably do. I've written a song, and it's on iTunes, and there's others that have, and we'll probably work them in eventually, but we want to just, you know, make sure that people, you know the music. But it's all 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s covers, you know, a couple of modern-day classics, you know, Tom Petty, Kiss, Pat Benatar, Joan Jett, T-Rex.
Oh, nice.
Shocking Blue, you know, there's some oldies
nice.
That, you know, you're just going to say, well, man, I haven't heard that. You get, you know, 8675309, you get Jenny
Greta,
you know, some really just cool songs, Bang a Gong by T-Rex and the Kinks and Lola, you know, so it's every Rebel, David Bowie, you'll know every song, and hopefully folks will really be receptive, at least they've been so far.
So when you decide, like, was it just the downtime that inspired you to pick up the guitar? Or, I mean, you mentioned Cheap Trick. Was there any other music that kind of inspired you to start playing?
Well, I've always wanted to. It's a bucket list thing. When I lost the election, I wanted to learn how to put together and take apart bikes, which I volunteered at a bike store and did it for a year. It was great.
Oh, wow. Nice.
So now when I get a flat, I actually know how to change my own tire. And I wanted to learn how to make sushi. I did that. And then I've always wanted to learn how to play the guitar. And I sang in high school and college and, you know, plays and jazz and show choirs and, you know, things, a cappella groups. So it's just getting the voice back, which has been fun. And I think it's pretty much there. And then the hardest thing for anybody who's new at it is to get up in front of people and sing and play at the same time.
Yeah.
And without looking at your chords. And, you know, I'm there, fortunately. And But it's just, if that's funny, my daughter said, "Hey, Dad, you're 61 years old. Like, what are you doing?" And I said, "Listen, Ayla, when I'm 91, you're going to be 61. Right. And when you ask me for, Dad, I really want to go into this new venture, I'm going to say, Ayla, what are you doing?"
Right.
You know? So, I mean, come on, I'm not dead. I'm in the best shape of my life. I love music. I want to get people outside and get them back into the groove that we all know and love as Americans, and, you know, outdoor beers, picnic, dogs, yeah, and hamburgers, enjoying each other's company, and music is the great equalizer. People can come together over music, sports, family, and food. Throw a little politics, it gets a little weird, but I'm so psyched to be part of this amazing, and they're very, very talented, you know, I'm the guy that is the showman, but able to kind of put it together, and really, it's been fun. Put it this way, when my daughter the other night came to a show, and then the next morning she says, "You know what, Dad? I was wrong. You know, you guys are really good. Keep going." So that's the kind of the accolade that I really was waiting for.
Well, Scott Brown and the Diplomats opening for the Eagles tribute with Pat Badger from Extreme there, Dark Desert Eagles. That's July 17th. That's coming up here at Indian Ranch in Webster. I got to ask you, are there any future plans to get back into office or some kind of service or anything like that? Or is this what you're doing right now? You're going to open the...
I'm the president, CEO, and dean at New England Law, Boston. People can go to www.nasl.edu. And certainly if they want to learn more about us, they can go to scottbrown-diplomats.com and learn more, certainly, and get on our website. But listen, I've always felt a need to serve. And anybody who's listening, I mean, you have people in the Webster area who I'm very, very close with. I won Webster. I won most of Worcester County and, you know, have a deep love and affection for Worcester County. So, you know, who knows? Right now I'm kind of turned off by politics, and I really need a chance. I've only been back since December 26th. I need a chance to kind of regroup, do my real job, have some fun on the weekends, and get to just see everybody and just give them a hug and a high five and a smile. It's really, really what I'm kind of looking forward to this weekend. You know, pray to the weather gods. I saw maybe a little bit of rain potentially, but who cares? We'll have a rain party.
Right, exactly. Well, you know, as you mentioned, I mean, if it doesn't work out, you can be a sushi chef. You can work at a bike shop. I mean, it's amazing that you've learned all this stuff. Play guitar, fix bikes, make sushi. Maybe you can incorporate that at the gig.
Yeah,
people can bring their bikes.
You know. Sleep when you're dead, and I've always felt a need to live every day as if it's our last, and you know, hope people take that advice and really just come on out, say hi, and you know, it'll be great. So, and we're honored. Pat and that band, I saw them at Hampton Beach Casino the other night, sold out show. Unbelievable.
Yeah, they're very good. They do a great job. All right, well, Scott Brown, thank you so much. Scott Brown and the Diplomats opening for Dark Desert Eagles. You're going on, you said, about 1 o'clock over there at Indian Ranch.
Yeah, 1 o'clock to 1:45 sharp. They made it very clear.
We'll get there early and check out Scott Brown and the Diplomats. And thank you so much for taking
the time. Thank you, guys. Hey, have a great day. Stay safe. Bye-bye.